Edmonton, 1939, bicycle license number 4658.
When Edmonton City Councillor Ed Gibbons found what looked like a license plate for a bike,
it was probably when we were cleaning my grandparents' house out in the city.
He never thought it would come in handy.
I figured, hey, if you guys want this so bad, maybe you want to pay for a license.
The veteran politician raised eyebrows when he proposed licensing bike commuters like the city did back in the day. Not kids, but adults saving money by ditching petrol for pedals. He says it's not about a tax grab, it's about knowing who and how many are actually using city bike lanes.
Those that think they've got their toe in the door because they're, they got bikes and they can ride them and they can do whatever they want with this social engineering council, then they should think about how and why there should be some other way of tracking them.
Gibbons says he's gotten equal calls for and against his idea. He says it would show if the city is getting its money's worth spending millions on new lanes. He also says constituents complain lanes take up prime parking in front of churches and schools.
Licensing bikes is regulation for the sake of regulation.
Cyclists note at less than 1%, the lanes are only a fraction of the city's budget.
What we really need to focus on is building that bike infrastructure, making places that are safe for cyclists to ride, instead of creating more barriers.
Drivers have mixed feelings.
There's probably better things we can spend money on.
Do they ever get annoying?
Sometimes downtown, yeah, but everything's annoying downtown at rush hour, so.
Honestly, man, we need to make some room for these people out here. They gotta get their way on the road. Everybody needs to be safe. We gotta get a separate road for the bike lanes, man.
It's up in the air whether Gibbons' idea will catch on.
It maybe is a bit of a mischief type thing, but you know what? Let's get the conversation going.
Likely, it will keep rolling along. I'm Joshua Skernick, and this is a Sun News Special Report.